I'd say they're worn out. Amazed by the success that Mr. Pete had 3D printing gears for his Atlas lathe, I decided to 3D print myself some half nuts. And I got my scaling wrong on this one. I remodeled it up, but I was really surprised at how rigid this is trying to break it. And going from that, since I had to rescale it, I went ahead and just made them solid. And hopefully it works out. I doubt it will, but we'll try it. All right, well, we printed out new half nuts for our Atlas lathe. I printed them like this initially in this orientation. So the layers would be going in this direction. And I thought that would be kind of weak, you know, potentially breaking off of this flat platform here. So I printed them again, and I printed them square so they'd be more robust in this orientation. And the layers are going this way, so the pressure pushing against this is pushing against all the layers, and it's carrying that all the way down to the flat part. I already slid these in the piece that they go in, but I need to drill and tap these out. The program put a bunch of support in there. I deleted all the support except for the support for the holes for that. 1024 little stud. I haven't closed this vise. Well, this vise probably hasn't been closed in many years. So. Well, let's give it a whirl. Working on my 3D printed half nut project, and I heard a knock on the door. Turned out to be a FedEx guy with a package from Stan Sinkowski, which hopefully, unless he was playing a joke on me, now I could get that thing running. I'm gonna cut a recess out of this right here for clearance. I tried sanding it, but it's just gonna be too stinky and hot, so I'll just cut it. Here's the inside bandsaw cut. Take a lighter and burn these edges down like nylon rope. Just scrape them off. Let's give it a try. Even better than it was. I don't have the little detent ball in there in spring, so it's just force. Hell of a lot better than it was.
Okay, well, I'd say it works. It's actually a fairly decent surface finish, which I'm surprised about, considering my crappy tools. Let's see. We're going to bump it up to the equivalent to 64 threads per inch using that big round radius and see if we can't, I don't know. I doubt we're going to break them because I've been playing with it. There it goes. Well, in my opinion, I'm calling it a success. Well, for fun, let's throw a pointy tool on there and pretend like we're threading. See the thread dial there? We'll go 8 threads per inch. That way we can gauge the half nuts anywhere. Messed up beginning thread there, but yeah, it's all lining up. All in all, I'm really impressed with the capabilities of the plastic half nuts. You know, considering on eBay, they're depending on what you get. If you get old, new old stock or some new ones, they could be up to $80 or so, plus shipping. So for printing them out, does everything that I expect it to, so I'm happy. And I guess if you guys want, I can put the file on Thingiverse or whatever it is. I haven't used it, but I'll sign up for it if that's something that's desired. I won't add that relief in that I cut with the bandsaw because I believe it prints better when you it'll print better if you just do it the way I did and cut it out. It's quick and easy to cut it. So thanks for watching. Check me out on Instagram. If you're on Instagram, it's Rivers_Co.